I wanted to make a quick review of a 2012 BMW F650 GS that I bought and give some feedback on what I think about this motorcycle. On a scale of 1 to 10, I give it about an 8.5. It's a pretty good bike overall, but if you're thinking about buying one, I wanted to bring it to some things to your attention. When I was getting ready to buy the bike, I was comparing it against a Harley-Davidson Road King and a Yamaha Super Tenere. And one of the things I wanted to get was a liquid-cooled engine, which this has. Even though it says F650, it's actually an 800cc liquid-cooled engine. It's just a detuned version from the F800 series. So, same engine, just a little detuned. The cam doesn't open the valves as high, and it runs on regular gas instead of premium. Some of the things I like about this bike are it has Brembo front and rear brakes, and the discs are quite large. It stops really, really well. The balance on this bike is incredible. I can come to a stoplight, often don't even have to put my feet down if the light changes to green. I can just balance the bike quite easily. It corners extremely well. So all the handling characteristics of this bike are really good. I love the way it looks. It's a beautiful bike. I really like this color, sun yellow. That all part is great. Now, the things I don't like is it came with these knobby tires, which they're too aggressive for riding on the highway. They're noisy and they make a vibration at high speed. So I don't know why BMW put such aggressive knobbies on a bike that should be both on-road, off-road. These are really more like purely off-road or very low speed city driving and off-road type tires. So that's one of my complaints. The other one is this had lots of options on it I really didn't want. I wanted a stripped bike, but the BMW dealer says they don't come that way. They only come fully optioned. Well, one of the options is the tire pressure monitoring, which the sensors are located right here in the rims. And on the front tire, it's off by 5 PSI. On the rear tire, it's off by 6 PSI. So sometimes I'll get a triangle warning light that says I have low tire pressure, when in fact, they're fully inflated to their factory recommended specifications from the owner's manual. It's simply that the feedback circuit is so far off. I did look on the internet. I can't find any way to adjust that. So I think that's really rather stupid of them to build a tire pressure monitoring system that doesn't have any way to tweak it so that you can adjust it so that if you're using the proper gauge, and let's say you get 36 PSI on here, it shouldn't be reading 30 PSI on the computer. Which brings me to another point. This comes with a computer, and the computer is up here on the instrument cluster. And it's almost, I think it's just absolutely a terrible design, and I'll tell you why. If you want to read the tire pressures, you can go to that screen and read the tire pressures, but at the same time, it won't show you the odometer. And I'd like to be able to read tire pressures and odometer readings. I really don't care about outside temperature. I live here in Phoenix. It's 115. I know it's hot. I really don't care. It does show a gas gauge on the instrument cluster, and it does show the engine coolant temperature. Those are all good things. But overall, I think the computer is just a huge waste. I think it's a very archaic, antiquated design that was probably designed years ago. And it actually has, for example, a timer on it so you can time yourself. Well, that's not very applicable to most riders, at least anybody I know. So for me, that's not a good feature. Also, the seat that came stock on the bike was horrible. It was very narrow and it had no cushion to it whatsoever. So I replaced it with a Sergeant seat, which is a little wider and much more comfortable. What I think BMW should have done was had the seat a little wider and then maybe had an inflatable bladder in it so that if you want to ride it mostly off-road, maybe you want it real thin for that reason. If you want to ride it for highway and have some more comfortable riding, maybe the bladder would inflate and give you a little more cushion in here, which I think would have been a really great way to design it for such an expensive vehicle. Also, the windshield that came on the vehicle, or the windscreen, was very, very short and really very useless for anything. If you want to ride the bike anything above 45 miles an hour, you're really going to need a regular proper windscreen. So this windscreen I got from C. Bailey, and it's a 20-inch windscreen that's tinted, and it's absolutely perfect. So those are two of my biggest issues with the bike as it came stock, was the seat and the windscreen. Also, the handlebars are a little bit too low for me. I did order some risers from Wunderlich, and so those I'll install next week. And then also, if you look at the brake pedal down here, it's way far in, so it really, it doesn't line up between here and here. So I ordered from Wunderlich an extender so that it makes it easier for me to push the brake down. So that's another issue. I did add some rear safety bars. These are from Wunderlich. I really like these. These are not a necessity. It's just nice to have in case somebody was to push your bike over, or if it fell over, you could prevent from doing so much damage. I did have the dealer install a skid plate and then the front engine guards. So that's all good. And then I installed a rear tail bag luggage rack, and that's from Altrider. And then a genuine BMW motor rod tail bag, which is actually quite nice. It seems waterproof, has a lot of good features to it. And also I can now hang my helmet and lock my helmet here on this Altrider bracket. So the bike's actually pretty good overall, but I think it doesn't really know what market it wants to be in. It's sort of on-road, off-road, but not quite either one very well. So actually, if I was to do this over again, I would not buy a BMW. I would buy the Yamaha Super Tenere. And the reason being is the Super Tenere costs a little more for base price, but you get a lot more on it. Whereas on the BMW, it's a little bit less. I paid almost $15,000 for this tax title and license. Plus, I've added another $2,000 in accessories and all the special tools I've had to buy. So essentially, I have a $17,000 vehicle, and I don't think you're really getting your money's worth. One thing I wanted to note about BMW is things like this bag here, it's made in China. The first aid kit I bought from BMW is made in China. A lot of the accessories are not made in Germany. The bike was assembled in Berlin, but these parts come from all over the world, and so it's no different than buying a motorcycle, like let's say a Harley Davidson made in Milwaukee, where yeah, the parts are sourced from all over the world, and you know, so you're really getting a mix of parts anyway. It doesn't really matter where it's assembled. So I think with BMW, a lot of what you're paying for is a brand name, and everybody knows they're expensive, and they look expensive, and it's a good-looking bike. The other thing I wanted to make a buyer beware statement on is on the website for BMW, you'll find a lot of offers such as military discount, or in my case, I was supposed to get a Motorcycle Safety Foundation discount for having taken a course. And it turns out all of those options, even though they're offered on the website, are dealer decided. The dealer does not have to give you those options, according to when I talked to BMW of North America. In my case, the dealer didn't give me the Motorcycle Riding Safety Foundation reward, which would have been $500 worth of accessories. I complained to BMW. I wrote all the way up to senior VP and their sales and marketing manager, and they did make it right. It took 2.5 months, and I had to fight with them back and forth, but finally, they just to get me off their back, they made it right. But those are the things you should be aware of when you're going to the dealer to buy one of these motorcycles. Just be really careful. If the dealer doesn't treat you right, just get out and walk away and go to another BMW dealer, because I know there's some good ones and there's some really not so good ones. So in closing, I just want to say that be real careful about all these things offered on the internet. For example, this bike is offered on the internet stripped. You cannot get it stripped according to the dealer. They said it only comes from BMW of North America with a lot of things. Like, for example, I have heated grips. I'm in Phoenix, it's 120 degrees here. I don't need heated grips. It comes with the tire pressure sensors. I really don't need that. It comes with anti-lock braking. For me, personally, I don't need that. I'm a very cautious and slow driver. I'm not gonna be driving in the rain or snow. So that for me was just kind of a waste of money. The computer was a very expensive add-on. I don't need that. I just kind of wanted a strip bike. It's not available. So Again, when you look on the BMW website, it's going to show a lot of things like a stripped bike, but those are impossibilities. So just be aware when you're price comparing and performance comparing. For example, the Yamaha Super Tenere, it has a 1200cc liquid cooled engine and a shaft drive, which for just a little more than what I paid for this, would have probably been a better group of features. But I wanted a BMW, I wanted to support the homeland. You know, I wanted to get this wonderful brand with the beautiful logo. But all in all, again, it's my opinion, probably think twice about it. Don't buy on the brand name, buy on the quality. And if you want a bike like this, that's on-road, off-road, probably the Yamaha is the better one. Thanks for listening.